The aging process is unstoppable, finds an unprecedented study reported in today's Guardian. The article says, immortality and everlasting youth are the stuff of myths, according to new research which may finally end the eternal debate about whether we can live forever. Backed by governments, business, academics and investors in an industry worth an estimated $110 billion, scientists have spent decades attempting to harness the power of genomics and artificial intelligence to find a way to prevent or even reverse aging. But an unprecedented study has now confirmed that we probably cannot slow the rate at which we get older because of biological constraints, although the Quran has a different take, which I'll mention in a minute. The study by an international team of scientists from 14 countries, including experts from Oxford, set out to test the invariant rate of aging hypothesis, which says that a species has a relatively fixed rate of aging from adulthood. Quote, our findings support the theory that, rather than slowing down death, more people are living much longer due to a reduction in mortality at younger ages, said Professor Alberto from Oxford's Centre for Demographic Science, who analysed age-specific birth and death data spanning centuries and continents. He said, we compared birth and death data from humans and non-human primates and found this general pattern of mortality was the same in all of them. This suggests that biological rather than environmental factors ultimately control longevity. He said the statistics confirmed individuals live longer as health and living conditions improve, which leads to increasing longevity across an entire population. Nevertheless, a steep rise in death rates as years advance into old age is clear to see in all species. But the Guardian then says, but what has been missing from the debate is research comparing lifespans of multiple animal populations with humans to work out what is driving mortality. And this study plugs that gap, says Alberto from Oxford. This extraordinarily diverse collection of data enables us to compare mortality differences between both within and between species. All the data sets examined by the teams, Alberto's teams, reveal the same general pattern of mortality, a high risk of death in infancy, which rapidly declines in the immature and teenage years, remains low until early adulthood and then continually rises in advancing age. Our findings confirm that in historical populations, meaning in the past, life expectancy was low because many people died young. But as medical, social and environmental improvements continued, life expectancy increased. And he concludes, more and more people live to much longer now. However, the trajectory towards death in old age has not changed. Well, that's a perhaps not surprising conclusion. And a reminder of a verse in the Quran, which in Abd al-Halim's translation goes, it is God who created you from dust and later from a drop of fluid and then made you into two sexes. No female conceives or gives birth without his knowledge. No person grows old or has his life cut short except in accordance with a record. All this is easy for God. Until next time.